Oh, Congregation, please rise. Welcome. Welcome in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. We are gathered today to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, and to remember before God our sister Lorraine, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. We gather this day in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. At this time, as we begin our time together, we'd like to invite Melody and family to come forward and bring the eulogy on behalf of the family. So please come forward now, Melody. Those who are going to speak, please come forward now.
I want to thank everybody for your help, for being here, for me and my sister.
So thankful that you guys came. This is beautiful. I consider everybody here sending like this beautiful love and energy that we collected together to send my mom into the universe. We'll all come together with love, and we shouldn't be shy or anything because we all know each other. Well, selected you guys, and we're so thankful that you came. Let's send my mom out like with really happy thoughts and powerful, strong connections, and just positive. And thank you so much again for coming.
Yes, thank you.
We're going to thank Randy too. That was really awesome for coming. Sorry. Thank you guys, and then Jeff's going to come and say something. I'm a little upset too, I'm going to say, because I don't like cancer. It robbed me and my family too early. My mom was too young. I have resentment for that, but I'm going to do the best I can to make her proud. And thank you guys again. You know, I'm standing back and I'm feeling the energy of the drums and the traditionalism of my mom's, which she considered sacred, you know, and mixed with the Christianity, you know, and it brings us all together. And I'm feeling the energy. So if we can just come together one last time before we send her off and then send that energy up into the universe and get her good. All right. Thank you.
I had the privilege of knowing Lorraine from when I first started knowing Melody, and the first time I saw Lorraine, she had just this beautiful long dress, and she was so pleasant and just easy to talk to. Over the years, when she came back to the city, we had the honor of spending time with her more, and with her first diagnosis of cancer about 12 years ago, she stayed with us for probably a year and a half, and she was just dealing with it, with the things that went with it, with the hair loss and the, but she always had the positive attitude, and she liked it when first time I met her, I said, "Hey, Mom," and then she said, "What? I'm not your mom." It was just a kind gesture, and then in the last weeks, I told her, "You know, we love you, Mom," on FaceTime, because with the restrictions, we couldn't visit, you know, traditional ways. So Melody shared with me that she liked that when I talked like that with her. But Lorraine was quite diverse. She did some schooling in the field for helping battered women. She did some, as we can see out front there, there's pictures of her from when she graduated. And that was a joyous day. We went out to eat and we just celebrated. She accomplished that with a certificate, and she worked at the women's shelter for some time, and then she did other work, right? For helping people. And that was her nature, to help. On the other hand, she loved bingo. Bingo was exciting for her. And I think what it was more was the fellowship with friends or people and just being out there, you know, interacting with others. And even when she was fighting, in the end, she was still getting on the bus and going and doing stuff. She loved walking. She would walk all over from downtown to where we are, or she just was very active. And I echo the sentiment of, I hope someday, everyone hopes that we find ways to curb the impact of cancer on people's lives. I mean, it's impacted us directly with my mother and now Lorraine and others. So, Lorraine, you were one special person, and she still stood by her values of Christian values and her traditional values, and she had her Bible, and she always, when the girls were young, she always said that, you know, I took them to visit with the Lord and come to church. So, this chapter, Lorraine, we're going to celebrate your life, and you will always be remembered as a person full of kindness and sharing. And may you rest in peace. Amen.
Thank you, family. We will sing. We will sing our opening hymn, Amazing Grace. We can't sing, but we can read along and sing in our hearts. So we will read the hymn, Amazing Grace, together. Amen. rise. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. Amen. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Lorraine. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Our first reading today is from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. Here ends the reading. I invite you now, please, to turn to the Psalm 57 in our bulletin and to join me as we speak the words of the psalm together, Psalm 57. Be merciful to me, O God, be merciful to me, for in you my soul takes refuge. In the shadow of your wings I will take refuge until the destroying storms pass by. My heart is steadfast, O God, my heart is steadfast, I will sing and make melody. Awake, my soul, awake, O harp and lyre, I will awake the dawn. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, among the peoples. I will sing praises to you among the nations. For your steadfast love is as high as the heavens. Your faithfulness extends to the clouds. Amen. Our second reading, the Holy Gospel, is from St. John chapter 14. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. And Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you're going. How can we know the way? And Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Melody and Angela, Jeff and families, grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. You gather here today to grieve the loss of your beloved Lorraine. You are here with a lifetime of memories, years and years to remember, to offer up your own prayers of thanksgiving and gratitude for her life. We've heard all of this just a few moments ago in the tributes and the thoughts you've shared. I have not walked with you all these years with your mother. I have not shared really any of these experiences except for the few days and the few visits we had together in the hospital at near the end of her life. I saw Lorraine at her weakest and yet at her strongest at the same time. As she lay waiting out her final days in hospital, I had only a few short visits with her, some of them with you, family, some of them by myself. They were short visits, of course, because of her fatigue and her weakness. But we always shared a few Bible readings and prayers for healing, prayers for peace, prayers for Lorraine to know the presence of Jesus, the Good Shepherd, in that hospital room at that time. Prayers for Christ's hand to hold her in this last stage of her life's journey. What then will I remember of our few days together at the Royal Alex? Well, when I thought about this, the first thing I remembered was the quiet, confident nodding of your mom's head whenever I read the Bible, whenever I said the prayer. She couldn't do much. She was very weak. I remember her silent but clear nods as she said in her heart, yes and amen. Yes and amen to the promises of God as they were spoken and prayed over her. Those silent nods said everything that I needed to know about Lorraine's life and Lorraine's faith. They said that here was a woman who knew the promises of God well. Here was a woman who had learned them and lived with them, depended on them and leaned on them throughout her 68 years. And I would dare to say, and particularly in these last years, as she had to face the struggles and uncertainty of a cancer diagnosis and the long, challenging road, particularly, she had to travel these last 4 years. The last Bible verse I read to your mom on Tuesday was the psalm that we just read this morning, Psalm 57. And I want to repeat the first line of the psalm that says, "Be merciful to me, O God, be merciful, for I have taken refuge in you. In the shadow of your wings will I take refuge until this time of trouble has gone by." She received these words eagerly, her eyes closed, followed by the silent nod that I had grown to expect in our short time together. And I'm not surprised by the comfort these words gave Lorraine. She needed a refuge. She needed a safe place. She needed a hiding place. She needed to be gathered and protected under the wings of the God who was like a mothering hen protecting her young. The times of trouble, those, of course, in that time and place, were Lorraine's long and painful and exhausting battle with cancer, and that long time was coming to an end. Now it was time to rest. Now it was time to hide safely in the arms of the one who called her by name, the one whose love for Lorraine is always, always deeper and wider than any love that any of us can offer. It was time to rest. The mercy of God had come for Lorraine. And we say with Lorraine, yes and amen. "For I have taken refuge in you. In the shadows of your wings will I take refuge until this time has gone by." For Lorraine, her journey now is complete. Her past is concluded, and we have done well together, her family and friends, in honoring her this morning, looking back, remembering informally and in our time together, remembering her rich life and giving thanks for it. But we cannot end here. This cannot be our final word, because Christian funerals can never only be about looking back. Whenever we gather, we must also look forward. We must look to our hope, and most importantly, we must look to what will be in Jesus Christ for us. Christian funerals look forward. We look to the promise of what will be for all who are in Christ. We hear Jesus' words today in the gospel with joy and anticipation. He said, "In my Father's house are many dwelling places, and I go to prepare a place for you." And so we speak of hope. We speak of resurrection. We speak of Easter morning, even today. That day when, although we thought the cross had buried Jesus forever, he rose and said, "No, no to death. No, you are not the end. No, you are not the final word, because I am the way and the truth and the life, and I am risen. All who die in me shall rise with me, And until that day, I am with you always. So Melody, Angela, Jeff, family, friends, take refuge in this promise today. As you continue your journey of grief in the weeks and months to come, as you have to reorder your lives, beginning a new chapter without your mom's physical companionship, her smiles, her voice, her support, find your refuge, find your resting place, not only in memories and looking back, find your refuge and hope in the sure promise that Lorraine rests in Jesus and will be raised with him. Find your refuge and hope in the sure promise that the risen Jesus is with you now, today, lighting your way, your strength in weakness, your hope in despair. He is risen, and that means he is with you, present now, and in all of your days. He is risen, which means that he hears your prayers. He is risen, which means your future, your hope rests with him. He is risen, which means death is not the end. We pray in confidence that for Lorraine, those nods of yes and amen as she heard the promises of God in the hospital have now been fulfilled as she rests in the arms of her risen Lord, her refuge and her everlasting joy. And now, family, may this joy, may this same Lord be your refuge, your strength. May he hold you tight as you go. We say yes and amen this day. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. We will now hear our next hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Let us pray. I invite you to please rise. God of mercy, Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give thanks for Lorraine, for the grace and mercy she received from you, for all that was good in her life, and for the memories we treasure today. Remember your servant, Lorraine, and bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your reign, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on all who mourn. Give us patient faith in times of sorrow. Strengthen us with the knowledge of your love. You are tender toward your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal the memories of hurt and failures. Give us grace to use wisely our time here on earth, to turn to Christ and follow in his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life nor things present nor things to come will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us commend Lorraine to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Lorraine. Acknowledge, we humbly ask you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our final hymn is, Lord, Take My Hand and Lead Me. Please be seated.
Take my hand and lead me. No, I'm not.